It's Jesus is one of these ascended masters too. Like every time Jesus reincarnates, it's like the Zeitgeist said, right? I get this over here. Zeitgeist, Jesus fake. They tried to use it to make Jesus look fake, but he's as actually all these people potentially.
This is Horus.
See, he's Horus.
He is the sun god of Egypt of around 3000 BC. He is the sun anthropomorphized, and his life is a series of allegorical myths involving the sun's movement in the sky. From the ancient hieroglyphics in Egypt, we know much about the solar messiah. For instance, Horus, being the sun or the light, had an enemy known as Set. And Set was the personification of the darkness or night. And metaphorically speaking, every morning Horus would win the battle against Set, while in the evening Set would conquer Horus and send him into the underworld.
Yeah.
It is important to note that dark versus light, or good versus evil, is one of the most ubiquitous mythological dualities ever known, and is still expressed on many levels to this day. Broadly speaking, the story of Horus is as follows.
Yeah.
Horus was born on December 25th of the Virgin Isis Mary. His birth was accompanied by a star in the east, which, in turn, three kings followed to locate and adorn the newborn savior. At the age of 12, he was a prodigal child teacher. At the age of 30, he was baptized by a figure known as Anup, and thus began his ministry. Horus had 12 disciples he traveled about with, performing miracles such as healing the sick and walking on water. Horus was known by many gestural names such as the Truth, the Light, God's Anointed Son, the Good Shepherd, the Lamb of God, and many others. After being betrayed by Typhon, Horus was crucified, buried for 3 days, and thus resurrected.
So that's Jesus. Like a dream.
No, on December 25th.
He would dream that, and then he'd die, resurrect, go to heaven, and then again, he would. This life is a dream. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. You know what I mean? And then he'd be born again as. Well, he'd go to heaven in between.
Krishna. And upon his death, was resurrected.
He must be, like, he's your god, like, and then, the more times you do this, you can come here at will and go to heaven or hell or any dimension at will, the more you become an ascended master. So it's here, like, they say all initiations, so these are the initiations here, of these the incarnations, the different ascended masters of like Jesus and all these other people have mastered how to do this. You can incarnate, always do the right thing, build up good karma until you are able to break through. You can go to nirvana, or you can choose a trillion year journey through all different planets and solar systems for trillions of years, and then you are like a Jedi or whatever. And it's all here. I want to really find the one part where they were like, I don't know how I would find it. They're like, it's an initiation. So, this is it here. So this is a Theosophy Wiki. So this is their secret teachings they released to the public now. So Annie Besant, H.P. Blavatsky would talk about, you're in the Buddhic plane as a new initiate, born into the new life spirit, and it talks about the second initiation. You're becoming more powerful. Maybe you're psychic in this life. Maybe you got psychokinesis. And then the third, you're able to do your different bodies and travel astrally. You're like a pure witch then, like, or a prophet or something. And then the fourth, you know, you're becoming like Jesus or like a ascended master or something like that. High up, and then, you know, eventually you're like, you are God consciousness beyond this plane, and then you can come and go at will. And that's when the becoming a Jedi starts, or just going chilling in heaven or nirvana or anything. Traversing different planes like Chirinoga, the Celtic, the overworld, the realm of fire, the realm of hell could be the realm of fire or the land of the damned or anything. Like, you don't know, you can escape. There's ways out through You got Elf Kingdom, all these different mythical lands are real. Nothing new under the sun. You can't even make up stuff. Anything you create is drawn upon something that already exists, so even like lands of the fairies and everything's real. And you can go on and different traverse these different realms, even go to hell or Hades or and escape, go back up to heaven as like maybe seven heavens, if you could perceive to start with, thousands upon thousands of heavens up the way and thousands of hells down the way. And it's like eternal salvation would be doing the right thing, ascending. Eternal damnation would be doing the wrong thing, descending. You can make a principle that you always do the right thing, you'll stay afloat and rise. Or if you got bad principles, you think, or you just want to go to hell, you like bring it on, become a beast, you're going down. And, you know, go down through different realms of hell. There's a fifth realm. Demons see people up in the third realm. Ghosts that want to drink and want to smoke, and they can't even, they just watch people smoke and wanting to drink it or smoke it. Spirits in the fifth realm can see that and are envious of that, and they would see like joy of people brings tears to their eyes in a bad way. They can't even feel the joy. They're angered feeling the joy way down in the depths. But like life is like a cycle, like a figure eight infinity or something, right? In all different directions probably, but you can rise up, you become ethereal, angelic, air spirit, even alien, and become one with God itself, a seraphim angel, and just every blessing. And then you go down, you become human. Even I would see as you like dip your toe in the waters of life, if you're like a, say a lamb in a field, it's like an angel dipping his toe in, and the lamb comes, is born, is slaughtered, eaten, they pull their toe back out, and then maybe dipping in a couple more lambs or cows or whatever, mouse king or anything, and then they dive in, they become a human. But like you kind of get water in your mouth or drink it or go too deep, you become like a, you human, but then you become a plant or anything. Animals, plants, way down the earth spirits, gnomes, you know, it further down you become a mineral, a rock. You actually become a rock for thousands of years, and further down a demon. But, you know, there's all different realms you could traverse. Like there's a, you know what I mean? Alternate dimensions with no time. There's like a one where the Nazis won the war. There's one. There's a gay one. You go down the seven spheres of hell or whatever. There's one. You are maybe in heaven and every realm at the same time. Like a old video I have up. The guy was saying where soul fragments split into many different realms at the same time, imprisoned during time. Being messed with by something, someone, some beings, Elohim maybe, or Nephilim, or some predatory race might even. There was an extraterrestrial war in Andromeda or something, and one of the reptilians found a toe or a finger, a body part of a human, took it here, cloned it, and put it in this prison so subtle you wouldn't even know it was a prison, because you don't know about the bliss of heaven until you're out of here. And then you die, you reincarnate. Apparently if you turn away from the light, you can go back to where you're from and different, because the soul as well. So they could be incarnating humans and they're like torturing the ancestral memories of weaknesses out of us all through the monetary system, enslaving us. We don't even know we're enslaved. People supposed to pay you and everything to do stuff, potentially. Having to work all the time, no superpowers, don't even teach us pyrokinesis or psychokinesis, or you can create golems that do work for you. Why aren't we allowed to do that? And maybe we are golems, and as souls incarnating into them, and as all cloned from a human planet on this reptilian round planet, and they're trying to figure out what's our weakness for a war. Because we're supposed to have elongated heads and be super psychic, like we all are turning super psychic now. this is just a theory, but this could be true, that we will get, like, you can channel your heaven self as like an elongated head as well. And then further down you go, you turn into hell realms, because the us and angel is an angel, but the beings below are like lesser gods or demons, as the Greeks would say. Maybe a more accessible lesser god, but to them, if they're below us in lower realms or lower selves, we'll look like angels to them, and to us we look like demons to the angels. So we can access the lesser gods and the demons to climb higher to get the angels and ascend. Or it depends, because if you're an old soul, you're going down the way. You've already been down the whole way, actually, and you're returning back to your ascent up the way, and the angelic and air spirit self, fairy, seraphim, one with God, and then any number of things can happen. You go to many planets or descend back down again. And then a young soul is someone coming fresh out of heaven. Like, they say kids are like, they're incarnating from heaven. And so you can tell a young soul is very naive and doesn't really know much. Float the airy, like a clairvoyant air spirit, air sign. And then they're on their way down. So they gotta go down and get stronger and get beasted up. Get more aggressive and mean and angry like a demon. And the more further down you go, you gotta fight your way down the way. And by the time you're coming up, you're an old soul. You're more experienced. You've been through realms of hell. You've become a rock for millennia. You fought your way back out of it. You know, on the way back up again. Like, it's a feeding ground. Because the only thing we don't do that if we're in a dream and we're flying and stuff in this realm is eat and consume and drink and stuff and procreate. In our body could be like our mouth or whatever. You know, we could be the light. We're made of light, and our true self could be in the dream or in the higher realm. So we're like our own mouth or something. Like, maybe you're a human because you like the human diet and the human life. Maybe a sheep likes the sheep life and the sheep diet out in the field, or a dog, you know. But there's many different things. Like, you become a dog this life because you weren't obedient enough in the past life. You become like a, what would a gorilla goat be? You fought too much, or you didn't, maybe you didn't fight enough, or you didn't fight enough and laughed, or didn't laugh enough or something, or laughed too much. So you become a gorilla goat. What do you think out there? Because you'd be a sheep, you were too much of a free spirit, now you're in prison in a field. Or you could be, if you were like really fast running about too much, you become a tree even. Or you're too slow, you become a slug as punishment, or a snail. Maybe you pass the life of flying colors, you become a bird, and you can fly for a life, you know what I mean? And then, of course, a tree has a spirit, a tree spirit, and that's where fairy trees come from, is a tree spirit. Trees can move and talk and do light, the Baxter effect, and have spirit form, and are like an antenna to their angelic self, their fairy beings. That's where fairy trees come from, and that's coming back worldwide. You've seen trees hug people, and you can, a spirit of a tree can come out of a different tree in any time or place, in any part of the world, or any other planet probably. And then you think, is there underground layers, is caves down there that their antennas to breathe in CO2, which they can, they or exhale oxygen, is coming from underground. Do you know what I mean? Or, and then there's many, many theories I have that even a sheep, or even this clone, can be like sitting there, even someone in a prison, and they're like their own antenna to their spirit. They can go anywhere, and as long as they're safe. That's what you think. This realm is like a dream, like the hub of a dream. You come fuel up and keep yourself safe here, And then in the dream realm or the spirit realm, you can traverse places and walk about and be free, fly, teleport, astral project, and then as long as you keep your body safe, you're alright. And anybody not knowing about this may be a fool to smoke and treat themselves bad or put themselves at risk when you really should be just sitting in your house and doing your job and chilling out and then back into the dream. Dreams can last eons and you can go traverse time and space up there and then keep yourself safe. Even someone can do that. So that's amazing, like many different theories I have about that. So that's the key, the living key, Willie G. Let me check the time here, because that's really, but 1:22:22. But we're only getting into this because I'm trying to explain initiations, and that's how reincarnation is real, but heaven is real as well. So that was, I was reading that, and that's 6:04. So he is proud, knowing nothing but doting about his questions and strifes of words. That's me. I'm a like false teacher, because I'm a false messiah, false prophet, false teacher, because I did not know the truth. Like, for many, many years I was in spiritual darkness and didn't even know anything about God at all. So I'm trying to teach and you know, awaken people. Like, anyone like me at all that was like a Jew or non-believer, atheist, or not even atheist, but just didn't even look into scriptures, like agnostic or whatever, that wasn't even a known. That it is true, all this is real. The only reason any atheism even exists is to protect witches from getting burnt at the stake again. Any reason is not in the Bible, it's not in the laws, or it's not in any school books, is to protect witches so they don't get burnt at the stake again. Like the Inquisition and the witch hunts and all that there. So, always remember that. The only thing is, caused all sorts of idiots and profane people that just do not understand or know at all. And that's the main reason we don't get that's the main reason we're not allowed spacecraft or any of these superpowers, but by the powers that be. But you gotta find them, the truth, like, you know, that's going into it there, that's why. That's the reason why it's like that. Just to protect witches, so. That's me. I'm puffed up with conceit and understand nothing. I have an unhealthy craving for controversy. I'll play that. So that's out there, the Nations guy, but. D12, man. Instigator, one of my favorite songs. You know what I mean? Controversial, not commercial, homie. Like Big L's buddy said, Big L's homie.
Nigga, can't you see? I'm an instigator. Ain't nobody worse than me. I'm an instigator. I'll be the first to be, first to squeeze. Take heed to the words I speak. I'm an instigator. Nigga, can't you see? I'm an instigator. Ain't nobody worse than me. I'm an instigator. I'll be the first to be, first to squeeze. Till it hurts to breathe. Fuck with me.
I love getting shit started. Right. I instigate a peace talking to a beef talking to police. Need chalk to chalk you up. Have bitches walking up, smacking you in your face, screaming that you talk too much. Tell women you said you fucked them. Tell the hardest nigga you said you snuck them. Ran his pockets and stuck them. Till they gather in front of your crib, guns and long clips. Laughing when they shoot at you over the wrong shit. I lock down your block with lies. It's so believable you run and grab your shotguns, Glocks and nines. Walking blind, excite fights until they erupt. Instigate my own death, cause killing you ain't enough.
I don't give a fuck if we beefing or not. I squeeze first, I'ma heat up your spot. I'm a nigga that breathe dirt on these streets every day. Snatching niggas, yay. How you bitches needin' work? You can get it from me. I'm despiteful. I tie your hoe. I'm a maniacal fire animal, liable to leave you strapped with your Bible.
So that's what it is there, man. the King James Version, like, knowing nothing but doubting about his questions and strife's awards, were come with envy, strife, reading his evil surmisings. Like, because I was thinking, as I was reading that, I was thinking, like, what I was saying about you should embrace the good, the indulge and be hedonistic and sexual and, you know, sexual revolution and everything. You should smoke weed, you should drink, you should be merry, because why is Jesus saying, be not of this world, rise to heaven like leaven and bread, when you're just going to return here? It's more Buddhic in nature. Why the hell would you want, unless you want to go to heaven? He is probably from heaven, seeing heaven all the time, saying, please come to heaven, it's way nicer than here. But like I'm saying, when in Rome, why wouldn't you indulge in all, if you're going to be here, coming back forever? We got eternal life with all the worldly pleasures here, why the hell wouldn't you? And he's like, be careful, you fall down deeper into this labyrinth of whatever these interdimensional planes are that we're in. But, you know, as the world is interstellar, the light from solar systems hits us, because suns are actually a cosmic web, like they said in that. You know, it's a light bridge to the planet that you can traverse with even a spiritual spacecraft. So I was like, what's the point in not sinning? Why would you go against the grain? Why would you go against your own body, your own flesh, your own being, and not indulge in hedonism and sex and love and all sorts of different worldly pleasures, eating chocolate and good food and happiness and love and joy and stuff? But they separate that from the joy. They're like, you need the joy to be pious and pray and even suffer to have joy, which I didn't. And then I was like, they're probably just the first people with a printing press to be able to print this stuff up and take over the world. Maybe Jesus, I mean, it could be mob schemes, even Jesus, just a magician. And he took the whole parable about taking a deal with Satan was like, either he did actually take the deal and took over the entire world, because all missionaries, he's in every country worldwide. Or one of the apostles, when he ascended, they took the deal. Since Jesus, there's been many, many, many other mafia men or churchgoers, even believers of any kind, all sorts of secret geniuses smarter than Einstein, and all sorts of different people that's like Jesus since. And they probably all, like, thinking the same as me. They did take the deal that they took over every country.
Greece, born of a virgin on December 25th, he was a traveling teacher who performed miracles such as turning water into wine. He was referred to as the King of Kings, God's only begotten Son, the Alpha and Omega, and many others. And upon his death, he was resurrected.
So that's Jesus as well. I know we would ignore this here part, like. And of course, she male, like, angels are both male and female, and different. You could probably grow, like a orbs within orbs thing. That's their part of them, that you see that and hit that with a, you know, like a Yu-Gi-Oh card of some sort of
Mithra of Persia,
dodecahedron style thing that would be like sex and that kind of stuff incarnates these moon children.
He was also referred
like
to
your
as
man Rakastalu says.
Others. Interestingly, the sacred day of worship of Mithra was Sunday.
That is also Jesus as well, if I'm correct. And this guy is just trying to debunk this, you know. But again, that's just provoking controversy to look into it. Like, if you're watching that, you're like, what's going on here? We got the internet, we got books and all. You can buy any book. Look in there and let's see, you know what I mean? So I was like, they were like, that's evil suspicions, that's evil surmisings. And I was like, why wouldn't you indulge? Maybe witchcraft is better than this. Maybe it's mafia schemes. Maybe it's the opiate of the masses. Maybe the apostles is where it's at. Maybe Jesus never really did exist. Maybe they were like, how do we take over Judaism? And they were like, I don't know, to this day we couldn't, because blasphemy laws, you couldn't really ask these things, but I'm just saying, what if? It was a mafia style opiate of the masses that they wanted to declare even the Jewish prophecies of the Messiah, and then just say this older guy's the Messiah and mess up a prophecy or whatever. Because they did, they went into writing the Talmud and all the different Kabbalah and everything after this, I think. As well as, then again, you could think Jesus was just one Jewish man. Like they could all do this, and there's many people all over the world and all the secret societies can do these things. And these are the different evil surmises I was having. Because this is a history book. They're way back in the past. You think, why are they linking up with me, Willie G, a loser? Well, I'm in 2024, and I know all users out there, like all yous watching, are blessed now for life. You can get free pints at the pub, freebies from, you know, you'd be like, we call it DJ and Hustle and Flow. Terrence Horror, man, played him. Because I've been talking to him, like, through the videos and stuff. I was like, I need someone to get these ideas out. I know they won't listen to me, but feel free to do it yourself and get this truth out. And he went and did it, man. So, God bless him. But he's a pimp in that. So, you know, saying, if pimping was legal, you know, like in Germany, and you get free joints and then, or free hoes and free joints as well, because weed's legal there, which is a great thing, you know. Oh, he's out there again. You can brag, you get your money's worth out of watching this video that I'm actually in the Bible, and now you are as well, just from witnessing this. Like, these apostles of superpowers even back then can see us all. So you can brag for eternal life and get any amount of blessings that come from this that you want. You probably are unlocking powers like Jesus in you if you didn't already have them. And if you're psychic, you can know, you know what I mean? And then, I know there's another one there. 14 I was looking at. Then after that was, that thou keep this commandment without spot, unrebukable, until the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I was just like, there's one of someone around here had a dog called Spot one time, and I thought, geez, even Spot the dog's in the Bible. And it is revealed now to all you that, you know my rhyme, Molly whopping off with a tomahawk, you know all that there, off of the top of the noggin and not rocking your socks off if you're like I'm on the top of the pops, you know. And all that, I got the rhyme of that coming, like, you know, popping it, sop it all, trying to walk it off as a saunter on, eating a toffee pop. Spot the dog. Even, you know, the way them walk and talk, is it the moss of rocks talking, y'all? You can talk to God. Spot the dog, right? So, what is this commandment they're saying then? That's Timothy 6:14. 6:11, but thou, O man of God, flee these things and follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness. Fight the good fight. If they didn't do that, we wouldn't have the world we have today if people had just indulged in being satanic. Fight the good fight of faith, lay hold on eternal life. And they mean like reincarnation, they mean going and returning and stuff. Whereunto thou art also called. Is a rhyme, and has possessed a good profession before many witnesses. That is an invitation there. If you can figure that out, they're saying also called is now, like Revelations is revealed. I give thee charge, and alright, so you can get in, make contact, like get the Bible, spark up the light, and just say hello, Paul, and talk to Paul and Timothy. Through that, and has professed a good profession before many witnesses. I give thee charge in the sight of God, who quickeneth all things, and the quick and the dead, people quicker than time will never die. Before Christ Jesus who before Pontius Pilate witnessed a good confession, that thou keep this commandment without spot, unrebukable, until the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, that is like judgment day or whatever. He's saying all these things he's saying to do. And then, of course, 619 I went to then, underlined, that I've been thinking this entire time about everything in this Bible is age-old immortal wisdom handed down for generations to all people. Just as very nice, very brilliant, genius teachings that are essential for life. You need to read the Bible and understand it by the time you're 18 anyway. Like, at a young age, I think, if you can, get into the Bible, and even if you're older like me, these are essential wisdom, you know. Take it with a grain of salt is all. Because this is a history book, man. Times have changed, like. But these are still immortal wisdom, just passed on for generations. People was like, we need to remember this. Everyone should have this brilliant wisdom. So it's that this could be the chief cornerstone. Like all these videos, the chief cornerstone in the next schizomystic religion. All these videos, right? And all these, all this art I'm making, everything I'm putting up here, the chief cornerstone, like Jesus Christ. So you lay a cornerstone, like Jordan Maxwell says, on a house. Not the actual pyramid top, like the first brick laid, like Will Smith says, you lay this brick and then you can build a house on it, or build a wall, or what, you know what I mean? You lay this one brick, you can build a house on it. That's the cornerstone. The chief cornerstone, the first one. And I was thinking, this Bible is essential chief cornerstone to any house. So laying up in store for them a good foundation against the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life. That's what they mean, like reincarnating over and over. And rising to heaven. And all these different ways that we live eternally is what they've been telling everyone. That, I don't know, because of the witches trying to be protected, people don't understand, but Jesus did actually get crucified and die and resurrected himself like Lazarus, like a vampire. Yes, sir. Lazarus and vampires are real. And Jesus actually rose from the dead. Anything saying anything different is schemes to keep witches alive instead of getting the Inquisition witch hunts happening. So you can actually rise from the dead, and even if you do die, you reincarnate and are born again. And you can become giant form, you can become even small person, fairy or anything, gorilla goat, clone, you can become a chiphead clone and live forever. But why do that? You wouldn't go back to heaven every time, would you? 20 clones of you will all be you. You say it's near impossible because it's more nurture versus nature. Unless you implant your memory or something in your own clone. But you can see through your clone's eyes and stuff, they'll be saying on Gaia, you know. But like, it's more things you've been through and things you believe and learned and things. Your experiences and your memories are making you who you are. It's not just that. It's not just that you can just clone you. But aliens can actually. There's like the Tuatha and the Sea and the Venusians and all that. There can actually clone you, identical replica of yourself, as Linda Moulton Howe says, in her Gaia special about aliens. An identical clone of you, with all your memories and everything. But human cloning, I don't know if it's that far along yet. But that's what there's. I be rambling, vein babblings and vein jangling and stuff like that because of the Jimmy thing. So, That's what he used to do if he was drunk. But I've been taking, you know, I drank that whole time. I was getting a locust torture, and then they say, you know, schizophrenic, cryptodesic. It's a, you know, it's cryptodesia. It's a sixth sense. But if you're lied to, like, any, if you think you're crazy, you're going to be crazy and go crazy. So many years I thought I was just the dunce. I didn't know nothing. And then when I'd see the Holy Spirit, as every Catholic does, they would lie to me and say it's hallucinations, it's craziness. And then I started reading the Bible, I realized it's the Holy Spirit. So, thank God I realize what it is. I can never go crazy again, but it's like, it's just eternal, you know, so. That's why I do the vein janglings and stuff in the 20 here. As you can see, that's me. Willie G, the 11th key to the Bible here. Old Timothy, keep that which is committed to thy trust. Avoid and profane and vain babblings, and oppositions of science falsely so called. So, that's me, profane and vain babblings. I mean, profane as in you're not, you're a sinner, you're not, you're ignorant, you're not, you know, like even a Luciferian knows all sorts of wisdom. All sorts of genius things. Any religious person, any, even a dunce with an IQ of 120 that is not a telepath is an idiot. I hate to break it to you, but they're an idiot. Any believer knows people, everyone's psychic, miracles are commonplace, probably can traverse astral realms of different planets and everything secretly. Because it's a personal thing, you don't want to share it with someone who's going to mess with it. Never trust a stranger, only trust friends. If you want to share your magic with someone, that's why it's secret and that's why it's personal. Someone could mess it up if you tell the wrong person. So, profane is not knowing that, just thinking people's just sitting there, not knowing they're telepaths or smarter than Einstein. Everyone's smarter than Einstein. Any believer. Well, Einstein's a genius, but like there's many, many, many secret geniuses. So profane. Don't like a pig, the ignorant, pig ignorant. Never cast your pearls before swine. Never tell people in the street about these things. They'll just trample over when you care, whatever. They're like, oh, what? There's no free lunches in this world. But there is so. You gotta pay it forward, do the right thing, show people the truth. And of course, people will see. People know, people, even if they trample over it and don't give a fuck, it pays yourself up. Like I've been doing, I've been showing every single person, awakening them to their truth, and you know, I'm in the Bible. Give the charity and everything, and put money in a charity box, you'll show up in the Bible. Like, how are you even reading this? Bet you y'all put money, help to put money in a charity box, help a woman across the road. You know, give to the poor, look after the sick and needy. Any good things they got there, I even teach a dog to talk. And he tells his owner he loves his owner, and then a feather will drop from heaven. It's because it's a good deed will pay back itself to you. And only do good deeds that everyone has brilliant times in. So that's, if you're not like that, I'm only learning, so this is. I was profane, just thinking you're just sitting there watching TV or whatever. And vain as well, like vanity, you know. You know, only thinking of yourself or your beauty or your looks or anything, looking in the mirror all the time, vanity. You know, always obsessed with like nonsense, like stupid wee things or paranoid things or just think, oh, what does someone think of me because of this? Or not, you have to think of others way, way more. think way more people than yourself, you know. And then, of course, babblings, because if you are, like, profane, you don't even know people's psyche, that you could ask them questions, or you're just sitting there, even from over houses, you're not conversing. Anyone that thinks at all, they think they think, things just come to their thought, they're a complete idiot. Without even knowing, everyone's been made into idiots. Because of the witch hunts and inquisitions, they wanted it all kept secret. They had to take it out of the law. They had to make sure there's no way witches could get burnt at stakes anymore. In the modern day, there were no witch hunts. They had to dupe everyone, hoodwink them and lie to them that people were just sitting there watching TV. And the TV will send you blind. That's an old saying. Third eye blind. Like, you watch the TV, you can forget about the spiritual. You know, you see things in the ether. You don't even know. The idiot box turn you blind. Your square eyes watching the TV. As my granddad used to always say. You know what I mean? As vain babblings. So you're sitting there. I'm doing this on my own. Well, I got, like, you want to be group-minded with people, a hive mind. People give you, help you out with things to say, keep you right. You know, it could be babbling all nonsense. But I'm actually telling it, saying the truth, you know. So it's all about getting back into the group mind, the magnetosphere, the collective unconscious, the anima mundi. And just adjusting to being like a bull in a china shop. Just complete bull, idiot, doesn't know shit. And the china should start kicking and breaking everything. People could have millions of wee different beautiful things lined up. I come and say, blah, blah, idiot, ignorant stuff, knock everything down. But like, if you got spiritual discernment, you're attuned to the way you see things. You're able to see very intricate. Like, people could do light. I wouldn't even see what it is. It's that intricate and well designed. Nearly blind to it, but oversee. Because I was steeped in dupeness and idiotic non-belief. Dark, spiritual darkness. It's called a dark night of the soul. From Masons doing soul murder. Just rob your soul off. You don't even know about the spiritual. So profane and vain babblings is me. So then that we went from that then. I was like, I'll keep going. Because that's pretty damn cool. I'm in the Bible yet again. Touchdown. I make the message happen. It's not even like I could even stand in front of the Pope and say this stuff. It's not breaking any blasphemy law at all. I will as well if I have to stand in front of any politician, government, Pope, fucking world leader, anything. And I put my life on the line to tell you this is true. So here we go again. Unfeigned faith. And we go, what have we got? I was just reading this amazing stuff. So it is. 1:16. The Lord give mercy unto the house of Onesiphorus, or Onesiphorus, for he oft refreshed me and was not ashamed of my chain. Alright, no, wait, that's a different one. 2:16, so it is. But shun profane and vain babblings, for they will increase unto more ungodliness. That's me babbling away, like, I want freebies from, you know, like, DJ pumping free hoes and joints. I want free fucking drink, beer at the pub, free drink. You know, just mad perks for life. You know, I am the man. I'm in the Bible yet again. You know what I mean? And like, damn, Paul saying to Timothy, like, avoid that, you know. And then 3. I'm in that as well. 3. So that, and I'm giving out to you now. Something's annoyed me, like, because in the ether, things affect you. And I know right well, things affect me. And I'll be pissed off sometimes. I'm giving out to myself. And now they're like, the last day's perilous time shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves. That's me, I love myself, man. Big ego, I'm a rapper. You know what I mean? I got clues. Dr. Dre, Big Eagles. That's me. I love myself. I love myself. I'm not stuck up, but man, I know I'm a god. That's why I'm doing this. I've always known I'm a god. You know what I mean? I rap, but I'm just doing this. But this is what I'm in on this Bible. Like, you can... people can keep you down, man, if you let them. If I ever listen to some twat saying I'm an asshole, or someone call me a slur, some sort of mean slur, or talking shit about me, and if I believed them, I wouldn't be here, man. I wouldn't be in the Bible. I wouldn't be doing any of this. People are complete idiots. They talk so much shit. Like, people look at me like, oh, you're a loser. So I'm like, you don't know me at all. You don't know my... I'm a fucking genius. I'm a god. I'm destined for great things. You are a complete idiot. But I wouldn't even say that. I just think it's so irrelevant. I just ignore it. Like, just knowing I am the shit. I am the man. Probably from less than hip hop. I am a god. I am the beast. I am a fucking... God amongst men, man. You know what I mean? Big ego, I love myself, so that's what they're saying there. Man shall be lovers of their own selves, you know what I mean? Covetous. So you wanna do for yourself. Hedonism bought in Futurama. You know what I mean? I look all this stuff up, like, research when I was seeing, man. You want to help others, man, because we're not taught right in school because of the whole thing. But who's to say God's right?
I love life and its pleasures as much as anyone here. Except perhaps you, hedonism bot. But we need to be shut off, especially you, hedonism bot.
I apologize for nothing.
Ooh. Are you the calloused working man I ordered?
Sure. In order to fix your leaky roof, I need to spend 2 or 3 hours down here in the wine cellar.
I'll be upstairs putting batteries and things.
Mr. Hedonism Bot to see you.
Show him.
Very good, sir.
Ah, Fry, congratulations. Your latest performance was as delectable as dipping my bottom over and over into a bath of the silkiest oils and creams.
Thank you, sir. That's exactly what I was going for.
Linda, what began as innocent fun ended in tragedy tonight when a nuclear-powered robot stripper suffered a catastrophic reactor meltdown. There is only one survivor.
Everywhere I looked, there were piles of bodies, and then the explosion struck.
Hello, handsome.
Might I procure your services?
What do I have to do?
Oh, nothing sordid, I assure you. Simply vomit on me, ever so gently, while I humiliate a pheasant. Save it for the boudoir. Gentle bots?
You know what I'm saying? So that's what it is. Like, they serve themselves instead of others. Lovers of self, lovers of money. Covetous, right? Money's the root of all evil. Everyone's about nothing but money. That's what you want. Like, that's why medicine exists and nobody can faith heal. That's why people go out of their way to do some thing to get the money instead of pursuing some fun thing. That people work, everybody works, and nobody even knows you can create golems and stuff. That's why, because they just, the whole education, people, like Mark Passy would say, people is intentionally made to be solipsistic and everyone's satanic by default from the way the school systems ran and everything. and the media is broadcasting spells, broadly casting a spell on everyone's mind, blinding them, making them blind dupe idiots and everything. Just to downgrade everyone, so even the most noob Mason is like above everyone. You know, like arrogant. You know, I don't give a fuck. You know? I'd be shining. I'd be like, watch me, look what I'm doing. And it's I want to be shining. I want people seeing me shine. Even abusive, man, blaspheming, cause like hell, a lot of witches got burnt at the stake. So they all, everyone's like, fuck God, what's up with God? And since it is a history book, it is the next time of Earth. Since we broke free from this shit, it's like we invented all this technology. Maybe we shouldn't be keeping the damn commandments of God. I mean, Manly P. Hall says your energy feeds off if you start sinning and do the wrong thing. But everyone's a criminals and everyone's still grand. Nobody gives a fuck. Getting off planet soon, man, hopefully. And then you be disobedient to your parents. And they say, honor thy father and thy mother. But like that, we would never change if we did that. The old generation is stupid when it comes. They never even had the internet, so unthankful, ungrateful. Gratitude lets really help you if you're like that, but you know, it's just a matter of manners. You know. Well, if you're grateful for things, you appreciate them more. But the drive to get more, why would you be grateful? Why don't you go for new stuff? And of course, unholy. You know, because everyone's taught, like, anyone even sees this Holy Spirit, it's a hallucination. So, why do you want to be holy? Be a gangster instead, you know. That's the way it is these days. Whatever's cool, man, whatever's, like, in the spotlight, whatever people thinks they get into, you know, they like. But from being steeped in, well, a lot of dupeness, but a lot of gangster rap and different rap, hip hop and stuff. That's me. And then it even goes on to say more. Without natural affection, heartless. How could you be so heartless? No, Kanye West. Kanye West, man. Remember that, heartless.
In the night, I hear him talk, the coldest story ever told. Somewhere far along this road, he lost his soul to a woman so heartless. How could you be so heartless?
Look, we need to get Kanye obsessed with this AI voice thing.
Push talk up your
lick.
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 Push talk up your lick. West side will be right. Come quick with Dan. You claim to be a player, but I fucked your wife. We bust on bad boys, niggas fuck for life. Plus puppy trying to see me, we hearts are ripped. Biggie Smalls and Junior Mafia, some hard ass bitches. We keep on coming while we running for your juice. Steady gunning, keep on busting at them fools. You know the rules. Little Caesar, go ask your homie how I leave you. Cut your young ass up, leave you in pieces. Now be deceased. Lil' Kim, don't fuck around with real G's. Quick to snatch your ugly ass off the street. So fuck peace, I'll let them niggas know it's on for life. Don't let the West Side ride tonight.
pill, the no seat. Grab your thoughts when you see too far. Call the cops when you see too far. Oh, who shot me but your folks didn't finish? Now you about to feel the wrath of a menace. Nigga, I hit him. All the menace, nigga, I hit him. Nigga, I hit him.
First off, up your bitch and quit playing.
West side, when we ride,
come equipped with gang.
You claim to be a player, but I fucked your wife. We bust some bad boys. Niggas fuck for life. Nigga, I hit him.
Our mission is get Kanye West obsessed with AI voice conversion technology. We've sat through too much auto-tune like this. Kanye, how could you be so heartless hitting us with so much auto-tune and not one little, even Eminem using this AI voice conversion stuff.